Tiffany Arielle here, and we are back with another video in our Learn to Code series. So if you have not already, definitely check out the playlist, which I will have in the cards. You'll definitely want to make sure that you watch the first video so that you can have your environment all set up so that you can follow along with what I am doing. And you can choose to follow the rest of the videos in order if you like. However, if not, feel free to just jump right on in here. So today we are doing Checkerboard Karel, which again is in the same documents that we have been looking at this entire time. So it says our fourth task is to get Karel to create a checkerboard pattern of beepers inside an empty rectangular world as illustrated below. And you know, basically normal checkerboards. So this is what we have, you know, don't really need to explain a checkerboard. So it says this problem has a nice decomposition structure along with some interesting algorithmic issues. As you think about how you will solve the problem, you should make sure that your solution works with checkerboards that are different in size from the standard 8x8 checkerboard shown in the example above. Some examples of such cases are discussed below. It says odd size checkerboards are tricky and you should make sure that your program generates the following pattern in a 5x3 world. Okay. Other special cases you should consider are worlds with only a single column or a single row. The starter code folder contains several blah, blah, blah. Okay, it says this problem is hard. Try simplifying your solution with decomposition. Can you checker a single row or column? Make the row slash column work for different widths or heights. Once you finish a single row or column, can you make Karelville 2, 3, all of them? Incrementally developing your program in stages helps break it down into simpler parts and is a wise strategy for attacking hard programming problems. Then it says a long list of worlds that our program should work for. So CheckerboardKarel.py is the default. So I already have my PyCharm open. I've already created my CheckerboardKarel.py from the template like we have done in every other video. So I'm just gonna go ahead and set it up to use the default world, which I believe is the same as the 8x8 world, so I don't think it really matters which one we use. But what did it say? It said, let's try to do a single row or column. So let's do that first, right? Let's try to do just one row. So let's try to checker a row. And then of course we need to define checker row. So what did I just do? I don't know. Oh, okay. So how would we checker a row, right? So we put down a beeper and then we move two spaces and then we put down a beeper, we move two spaces, put down a beeper, move two, okay, whatever. Now let's try to generalize this a little bit because we'll definitely need this later. So we put down a beeper and then the next space we don't put down a beeper. So basically what we want to do is only if we didn't put a beeper on the last space do we put a beeper on this space. So the way that we can do this, actually let's pause. First, let's just fill up a row of beepers. Let's do that first and then we'll worry about the every other one. So how would we do that? So we need to put down a beeper first because we learned in previous videos that if we try to check if there's a wall in front of us, then what ends up happening is if we only have one column, we don't get any beeper, which is not what we want. And then we need to, while front is clear, because we're doing one row, we need to move and we need to put down another beeper. So let's just make sure that we filled the row first, run program. And it looks like we are filling a row. Cool. So now we said we want to do every other one. So we said, I only want to put down a beeper if I did not put down a beeper the last time. So how do I know if I put down a beeper the last time? So what we're going to do is we're actually going to do this. We're going to keep a variable and we're just going to call it beeper. And we're going to set it to true so that we know that we need to put down a beeper first. We're going to say beeper equals true. And then what we're going to say is if beeper, then put down a beeper. And then I'll just set beeper equals not beeper. Now, in this particular case, I don't really need to do this because you can see that I just set beeper equals true. So this is always going to be true. So I'm always going to go inside here and put down a beeper. Here it's going to say beeper equals not beeper. Again, I don't really need to do this because beeper is true, of course. I haven't done anything to it. So this one is always going to set it to false. But we're keeping this here because this structure will make sense later and you guys will understand why. And of course, we're going to do the same thing down here where we put down the beeper. So let's see if this will give us every other one. Okay, cool. That works. So that's cool. So that worked. So now what do we need to do? We need to move to the next. So let's write that function. So how do we do that, right? So if Karel is here, Karel needs to turn left, move, and then turn left again. So let's do that. Turn left, move, turn left. So let's see if this works. Run. Okay, cool. That worked. Okay, so now let's see if we can just repeat this again and again. So how do we know when we are done, right? So Karel's gonna come here, she's gonna come here, she's gonna fill the row again. So how do we know when Karel stops? So let's pretend, right? So we did this and we came here, 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 here. So now once Karel is here, she's going to turn, she's going to try to move up, and she's going to realize there's a wall. So once again, we have our like while front is clear. But, you know, we've had this problem before. We can't just check if the front is clear there. We need to check if the front is clear right before Karel moves up. So that's what we're going to do. We're going to say if front is clear, move. If the front is not clear, I'm going to return false, saying, no, I was not able to move successfully to next. If I get to the end of what I had before, then I will return true, right? So here we're gonna do this. We're gonna say next equals move to next. And how are we gonna do this? Let's do this actually, next equals true. And then we'll do while next, we will checker the row and then check for next again. Will this work? Let's find out. So far, so good. Oh, this is not good. You can see Karel is running in a loop, which is not what we want. So I'm going to just close this because I know that Karel is just going to keep going in a loop forever, which is obviously not what we want. So what is the problem? Let's look at the picture. So here, Karel goes this way. Karel turns left. Karel goes up. But now, if Karel is coming this way, Karel is already facing to the left. If Karel turns left, she comes back down. Karel doesn't need to turn left. We need Karel to turn right. So how can we figure out which way we want to do it? Now, we could do a similar thing with the beeper where we say, okay, well, if we turned left last time, we need to turn right this time, but let's see in our handy dandy reference guide if there's anything that would help us. So we have front is clear, beeper's present, beeper's in bag, left is clear, right is clear, facing north, facing south, facing east, facing west. This might actually help us. So if you notice, when Karel is here, Karel is facing east. East is to the right. So if Karel is facing east, I need to turn left. Now, if Karel is facing west, I need to turn right. So let's try that, right? Let's try in our move to next function. So we'll say if facing east, turn left, else turn, right. And this is red because our turn right function is missing. So let's copy it from somewhere. We could write it again, but we're lazy, so we don't do that. We just copy paste. Okay, and then same thing down here where she turns left. So let's see if this will work. Let's try this now. Let's run. Oh, this doesn't look right. Karel is just going up. What is the problem? Let's stop this. Okay, so we said if Karel facing east, turn left, else turn right. If front is clear, move. Oh, now, let me show you, right? So Karel was facing east when she got to here. She turned left, she moved. Is Karel still facing east? No, Karel is facing north. But the thing is, she's not facing west either, she's facing north. So if you look at this one, I'm saying if facing east, turn left, I'm saying else turn right. But this is supposed to be only if she's facing west, but she's not facing east or west. So we're just turning right. And so I didn't want to turn right. I wanted her to turn left again. So that's how I know something is wrong. So what I need to do is I need to determine which way I'm supposed to be going depending on which way Karel was facing at first. Not after she turned, but at first. So what we're going to do is we're going to say left equals facing east. So I'm just going to store whether or not Karel was facing east inside this variable left. So basically saying, do I turn left? And yes, I turn left if Karel is facing east. So then everywhere here, I'm just going to say if left, then turn left, otherwise turn right, right? Seems straightforward. If left, turn left, blah, blah, blah. Okay, let's try this again. Okay, this is better. So I'm gonna make her run faster just to see to the end. And cool, this looks correct. All right, so are we done? Let's try some other world. So what did they tell us to do? So they told us to try this 5x3 world. So let's try that one. Let's try 5x3 run. Could not find world file with name 5x3. Okay, let's find. Okay, well, we have 3x3, so let's copy 3x3 and let's make it a 5x3 because why not? And dimension 5x3. Okay, save. Let's try this again. Okay. Oh, what? This is not what we wanted. So as you can see, I'm just doing bars, but this is not a checkerboard. So something is wrong. So what caused this problem? So is the problem with moving to the next row? Doesn't look like it. It looks like we're able to get through the different rows correctly, but it looks like the problem must be with filling the row. So let's go to that function. We have def checker row. Beeper equals true. If beeper put beep. See, this is what we said last time. We said beeper is always going to be true at the beginning of the row, which is exactly what happened. This was the beginning of the row. This was the beginning of the row. This is the beginning of the row. This doesn't work. So what we need to do is instead of setting this to true in the beginning of this function, we need to set this like somewhere here. And then we can just reference it as a variable inside this function. And of course, we may make updates because as you can see here, I'm writing beeper equals not beeper, beeper equals not beeper. So I don't know for sure if this value is going to be the same once I finish this function as it was at the beginning, right? So in this particular case, it actually wouldn't be. Because that doesn't make any sense. So an odd number, so let's say beeper would be true, false, true, false, true. So after I do this one, it would be false again, right? So when I get to the beginning of here, it should be false. So if I don't return the value from here to this row, then it's gonna be confused. It's gonna still have the same thing as what it had before. So let's try this again. So beeper, blah, 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 let's stop. And let's try this again. Run. Okay, this seems like it's working. Yes, okay, so this worked. Okay, cool, so now what else do we have? So we did the 5x3, it says checkerboard Karel. Okay, we have 8x1 and 1x8. So let's try those. 8x1. Run program, Okay, looks fine. Let's try 1 by 8. So far, so good. Yep, seems fine. Okay, what else do they tell us? 7 by 7, 6 by 5. Okay. Cool, 7 by 7 is good. Okay, 6 by 5. Cool. What else do we have? 3 by 5, 40 by 40, 1 by 1. 3 by 5. Run. Fast. Looks good. Let's do 1 by 1 first because I think the 40 by 40 might take a while. So let's do run this. Yeah, this is easy. Okay, so let's do 40 by 40. Run. And we definitely need to make sure this go fast. Ooh, this is still slow. Okay, so while this is going, let's do something else, right? So one thing that we did here is we have this variable. And we're passing it in and we're returning it back. There is another way to do this. So what I could do instead is I could define this variable outside in the global scope. And so when I do that, I don't need to pass it in as a variable. So I can remove all this stuff. Now you can see that this is red because it's telling me it's unresolved, but the way that I can fix this is I can just type global beeper. And so basically what I'm saying is that I want to use the variable beeper that's from the global scope. So since I'm using, I want to use the same variable, and so that's all I have to do. So I think this will also work. So let's go back. It looks like our 40 by 40 is complete and it does look correct. So now with our updated version, let's try the 8 by 8 again, just to make sure we didn't break anything. And we are good. So, success, we have programmed Checkerboard Karel. So if you did enjoy this video, definitely go back and check the other videos in the series. I do have probably maybe another 4 videos or so in the playlist. And additionally to that, definitely make sure that you come back next week for the final video in the Karel series. There will be more tech videos coming after that, so don't worry. And if you have anything specific that you guys want to learn how to code, like any fun math problems or anything like that, definitely comment those down below and we can probably work on those too. And in the meantime, don't forget to like, subscribe, and share with all your friends. And I'll see you guys next time. Bye.